This is a call to all South Africans who are committed to a non-racist, non-sexist, non-discriminatory, democratic future. Join us in this first lesbian and gay pride march too.
Uniting the fight for basic human rights of all South Africans, including lesbian and gay men.
Mobilize against discrimination.
Assert the role of lesbian and gay men in the current process of political change.
Confront South Africa with the presence of its lesbian and gay community.
Dispel myths nurtured by years of discrimination and stereotyping.
We challenge the Parliament to decriminalize homosexuality by legalizing all private consensual conduct between adults.
We challenge the law to recognize long-standing lesbian and gay relationships by giving them all the benefits afforded heterosexual couples in insurance, pensions, adoption, and taxation.
We challenge the political organization to adopt a Bill of Rights that protects lesbians and gay people from discrimination and guarantee them the right to express their sexual orientation in a free and responsible way.
We challenge the liberation movement to embrace the struggle for lesbian and gay liberation as part of its commitment to free society from all forms of oppression.
We challenge the religious tradition to accept their lesbian and gay members unconditionally and acknowledge homosexuality as a valid expression of human sexuality and not as inherently sinful.
We challenge the media to present images of homosexuality in responsible and appropriate ways that counter the dominant negative myths.
We challenge the employers to give opportunity to lesbian and gay people on grounds of merit and not to discriminate against them purely on grounds of their sexual orientation.
We challenge the health services and the welfare organizations to offer the same professional quality of service to people regardless of their sexual orientation.
We challenge educational institutions to combat ignorance and prejudice through a responsible sex education program that includes discussions of homosexuality.
We challenge parents and teachers to give us the opportunity to expose lesbian and gay teenagers to positive, responsible role models.
On Saturday, the 13th of October 1990, the first Lesbian and Gay Pride March took place in Johannesburg, South Africa. The theme of this year's march was Unity in the Community. This march, hosted by GLOW, the gay and lesbian organization of the Witwatersrand, attracted over 800 people from all walks of life and all parts of Southern Africa. This march is the beginning of our ongoing visible protest to change homophobic laws and discrimination in South Africa.
Yeah. Hello.
Where is that? What about the other slogans?
I don't know actually,
because
these are very
really
cute.
Yeah, where are these? Hillbrow's gay all the way. What a lot of fun.
The closet's gone. We have one.
Come
this
watch,
is
see.
Our.
What?
Out of the closet, into the street. Out of the closet, into the street. Out of the closet, into the street.
And harass those ones inside.
You're actually the servants of this march. That might sound as if you're not going to enjoy the march, but I'm sure you are going to anyway. What the idea is that we are going to line the streets and keep the march regimented. In other words, we're going to keep the march contained. We don't want people in the march giving out pamphlets, running around, speaking to people.
A time that we fight for the right to be who we are. For the right to love who we want to love. This is about time, and today we're making history. And thank you very much all for being here. We're all very proud of you.
We have many people here today from all over South Africa.
A group of lesbians who are organized in the ANC in Cape Town express their support by saying lesbians and gays have, over a number of years, contributed to the struggle for non-racialism and non-sexism and democracy in South Africa through their work in progressive organizations. We look forward to the time when lesbians and gay men can be open about their sexual orientation in their organizations without fear of discrimination.
We now invite a very young, dynamic Dominee from the Nkoli to come and address us, Hendrik Pretorius.
Firstly, we want to say to the rotten and dying traditional churches in South Africa, for too long have you been busy with your own ghetto philosophies, with everything but the core of the gospel, with a racial ghetto philosophy, with a sexual ghetto philosophy, with a socio-cultural ghetto philosophy. The graceful God, the graceful God, is no longer in your frozen theologies, your cold churches, your soulless seminaries, and your sanctimonious fierceness. And as long as this is the case, I cannot remain in the church. And therefore, I today announce my resignation as member of the Dutch Reformed Church.
Ladies and gentlemen, friends and comrades, this meeting and this march today have a message. We have a message to all the lawmakers of South Africa, a message to all the constitution makers of South Africa. That message is the criminal law is for criminals. Gays and lesbians are not criminals. Being gay and being lesbian is, as Hendrik showed us this morning, part of being human and being part of everything in this world. To criminalize gays, to criminalize lesbians, is to criminalize part of normal human society.
We should like to introduce you to Simon Cordy, human rights activist.
This is what I say to my comrades in the struggle who ask me why I waste time fighting for Morpheus. And this is what I say to white gay men or women who ask me why I spend so much time talking about apartheid when I should be fighting for gay rights. I am black and I'm gay. I cannot separate the two parts of me into secondary or primary struggle. They will be all one struggle. In South Africa, I am oppressed as a black person, and I am oppressed because I am gay. So when I fight for my freedom, I must fight for both oppressions. And all those who believe in democratic South Africa must fight all oppression, all intolerance, all injustice. With this march, gays and lesbians are entering the struggle for a democratic South Africa where everybody has equal rights and everybody is protected by the law, black and white, men and women, straight and gay.
much. I mean, we are showing the world that we are part of that here. So we've got to, I mean, the world should accept us.
Thank you.
Yeah, don't.
Yes, Martin. Who are you?
Of course, yes.
Significance. The significance is that we are proud of who we are, and we want to show the world that we're proud. That's all.
Let's go.
Change people, they can only change themselves, and I cannot pass judgment on anybody. I must first look to myself.
Well, what can we say? They cannot be given their rights. What can we do? Everything's changed.
Where's Simon? Simon, where are you?
And the lesbian gave him a bigger, bigger, bigger! And now we're going to just show our most peaceful demonstration. Look around you. All ladies and gentlemen, look at the person that you love, you like, hold hands with that person and give it a big kiss. And now, after we have done that, let's all hold our heads as a sign of unity and sing a song.
Me, I would like to say thanks for this march, because I've been willing for some years to be free. So maybe this time I'm going to be free, really.
How do you feel after the march?
We really enjoyed it, because it was for a good cause.
And you, sir?
I feel the same. And, you know, we had about 800 people for the first march in South Africa. Or in, let me talk about in Africa, you know. And we hope next day we're going to have more than people. We're going to have this annually.
And so you're a very happy man today.
I'm very happy. You know, I feel like crying. I feel like just tearing my clothes off. I don't know. I'm just like so happy.
The same sex. Now the people they are taking you as a witch. So there be those things of witchcraft. So they can throw you with stones. They can burn you alive. So you're afraid of those such things.
Again, no, as a lesbian, but I can never ever stand it saying gays and lesbians being oppressed, you see. I can't stand that thing, you see, because that is unjust.
What a nice message to the lesbians and gays, that they must pass it to Benny Alexander. I'm a black lesbian and I'm proud of that, and I was born like that and I was never influenced by that. Manda!
Some days after then, I met him with Funeka. I said to him, yeah, now you are gay with a girlfriend. And he said to Funeka, tell me since you are my girlfriend. And Funeka said, no, I'm not his girlfriend. I'm a lesbian. She just came straight to me and said it like that. I got shocked, you see, because it was the first time for me to meet a lesbian who is that bold, you see, who would come straight to me and tell me what she is. I said, oh. I just said, oh, but I was still trying to reconcile with the shock which I had in me.
It was now the first time that I have an affair with a lady from Stakastad. So I end now my relationship with the man in 87. From that now, the people were harassing me all over the sky. I was beaten by the police and the family of the lady also rushing after myself. I decided to move out from the sky. I go to George. When I go back again in 1990, I discovered that she was pregnant. I think it was when now I lose manners. Started taking liquor, taking taha, just because my problem was that I'll never get another lady, just because no lady will want to have an affair with another lady, just because I didn't know anything about gays and lesbians. So I moved from Siska at my home, I go back to George. And even George, things were very worse. I decided to come in Cape Town. So in Cape Town.
Generally, the lesbians and gays, the main problem which they are facing is that of being ostracized by the community. Because people think that it's something like a witchcraft to be a lesbian or a gay, or something very much abnormal.
When I try to understand to the TV, gay and lesbian, I understand that is where I belong. But I don't know how can I get those people. And then Desiree gave me an organization saying that is a black organization in I don't know, in Musenberg or Hood Bay. It was at Abigail, and the name is Midi. I see the name Midi, and I thought that really means this is a black organization. I moved back. I told it on a Sunday afternoon. I phoned for Midi. I found out that. No, it's a colored lady. And then Midi told me that I must go there, and then I go to Abigail. So when I go to Abigail, it was the first time then I met a man of the lesbians and the gays. So it was where now my life has changed in Abigail.
Abigail, viva! Forward, Abigail, forward! Forward, the nine racial homosexual organization, forward! Amandla! Amandla! I'm Funeka from Kailicha.
Funeka approached some members from the ANC Youth League here. And she explained to them that she was a lesbian, and they got shocked, you see.
Ingqondo yakhe yaxelela ngomfazi, ingqondo yaqonda, because i-feeling zendoda xa udibene nendoda like uba ndikhowushe ngoku, yaqonda i-feeling zam zandixela uba ngumfazi lona, ndizawukhowusha indoda.
They suggested that there must be a meeting, you see, with Abigail, because Funeka told them about Abigail. And in that meeting, okay, I was called into that meeting.
So I love you. I want to fall in love with you, not with another girl.
Yeah.
So how are you going to feel? Are you going to be free or what? Or you need to fall in love with another man?
Me personally?
Yes.
Mm. I'm gay. They'll ask questions and we're open. And as a result, in the ultimate end, yes, they committed themselves in helping Funeka this thing, being open, you see, about the life of gays and lesbians, and what gays and lesbians are, and all those type of things.
But perhaps, and I'm saying on behalf of Kosas, we are prepared to defend you politically. I'm still maintaining that position.
It has to be the gays and lesbians who will have to stand up, yes, and ensure that gays and lesbian rights are enshrined into the constitution. But definitely the ANC will give support, but gays and lesbians will have to take the this thing, the lead. Okay, that won't be enough. Because to just for those rights to be there, to be enshrined in the constitution, that's not enough. You see, things can be there, written there, but in terms of practice, then that will be a problem.
And I say to them, Viva Glo Viva. And I wish to welcome all the people who are here, those organizations like the Durban Sunday Women's Forum. We welcome you. We welcome the Transvaal Organization of Gay Sports, Gay Advice Bureau. We welcome the Abigail and other organizations, which I don't have a list of them here at the moment. But without wasting time, I welcome you all, and I hope this march is going to be as successful as the other marches.
Actually, in a black culture, you know what they say? They say it's come from the white people, and they don't believe there is a gay or a lesbian. You know, it was very important for me to come to the march, and especially for the black people also, to show people that as we, there are black people who are gays and lesbian, and to show them that we are around, even, and to show those who are in a closet that come out, their friends, come and join us.
Now!
I feel very proud and very happy because there's much improvement this time, and that the number of people who attended is more than the past years. And I'm very happy because everybody is happy. Well, I fight for people who are like me, so if they are happy, I'm also happy.
The way I see it, is that our societies have been so conservative to an extent that this conservatism has resulted to the oppression and exploitation of a lot of people, you see. Exploitation and oppression in the name of tradition and religion.
And what I like with the march, the people who were marching is, they didn't like insult the Christians. They were telling, singing the song that God love us all, God love us all. I like that. I mean, it's not like the Christians who thought that we are sinners, you know, they were preaching this and that and that. Instead, the gay people, they were saying, God love us all.
Shame on you, shame on you, shame on you, shame on you.
I represent Sunday's Woman, which is a lesbian organization in Durban. And I think the march was great. I think the most interesting part were the Christian protesters on the side. And the reporter from the Star was chatting to me and asked me why I thought that these Christians hated us. And I think that he had misrepresented what was actually happening there. I don't believe that the Christians actually hated us. I think what they hated was the homosexuality in themselves. And that's what they were struggling with. We represent, I think, for them, that part of themselves that they cannot represent themselves. And so I think that the march was beneficial for them because it gave them a chance, albeit outside of the demarcated area, to march as gay people in the club. And I welcome them to our march. What did we do last night? We decided that we needed to combine organizations from various centers, and we felt that the best way to do that was on a personal level, because organizational things tend to be very anti-personal. And so we felt that it was better to operate on a personal level first and then see if we could get an understanding of organizations through that. So we came to a good personal understanding of each other in the biblical sense.
How much of it? Can you promise me my mother is never going to see this video?
Hi, Dad.
I think one of the things which gays and lesbians will have to campaign around is for them to have the rights, you see, legal rights, to operate openly, to be able to marry each other, you see. That's the first thing, which I think is an operation on its own. And to open up the media, mass media, to gays and lesbians, you see, so that they can air their voice, you see. They can educate people about being gays and lesbians through radios, TVs, and even newspapers and magazines. The education department should open up way this thing, the doors for gays and lesbians to come to schools, you see, and run workshops, you see, and explain to pupils what it is to be a gay and a lesbian, especially to high schools, because that's where the students start getting curious, you see, wanting to know a lot of things, you see, and if they don't know this thing, they immediately attribute it to something supernatural.
Well, I'm Sibongile Sikulu. I live in Cape Town. I belong to an organization called Abigail. It's a new organization. It's a non-racist organization, and we're fighting for our rights. I hope everybody in Cape Town will understand us, and they'll join us in the new future. Thank you.
I think GLOW has got bright futures because it started with a low number, but now it's progressing and it has developed many chapters. Yeah, so the future will be too bright.
You'll find lesbians having an attitude towards bisexuals having an attitude towards gays, but the very same people are all ostracized by the very one common enemy, and that is society. And the other thing which I don't understand, okay, but this is part of human nature, but I don't think it's good, and that is that people forming up a lot of different organizations which are so antagonistic towards each other, you see. Instead of coming together, okay, even if they don't come together, but work towards forming a common strategy which will help them facing the common enemy, which is us heterosexuals. Really.
Exciting. I mean, everyone has got their own rights. I mean, they've got the right to stand up for themselves and what they believe in. Personally, I've got nothing against it.
What do you think of gay rights?
Well, I don't really know what to say. But I mean, everyone must live their life the way they want to, and we can't make decisions for them whatsoever.
God loves you.
What do you think of gay rights? Do you think gay people should have equal rights?
Yes, I think so. You are human just like us.
Yes, tell them.
What do you think of the march?
Something good, actually.
If they are right, I mean, they are showing them what they are feeling are. And they are proud of being themselves.
What do you think of gay rights?
Gay?
Gay rights.
I don't know. Honestly said, I don't know.
You think gay people are normal?
I can't say, I don't know. You know, because I'm not gay, I can't say what's going on in their mind. Maybe if I was gay, I would have been different, but...
What's your opinion? Do you think people should have equal rights?
Yeah, well, if they want to do it, they want to do it.
Hello, what do you think of the march?
No comment.
No comment.
Well, I don't know. I found it fantastic. It was the first march that I take part in. And it was quite an experience, and I hope I'll be here for the next 10 marches that we have.
I'm so happy to be at Lisbon anyway. For my side anyway, I'm not ashamed to say it. Even if I find problems with other people, but I'm happy to be at Lisbon.
You have to prove yourself.
Because I enjoy, you know what, to be at Lisbon is not something that you want to be. You choose it or anything. It's something that you feel. And the minute that you come out, you accept yourself, now it's over. Because you get frustrated to be a Lesbian or gay. Then after that, you accept yourself, oh no, it's nice. You know, you enjoy life like anyone, like everybody.
Well, is this to show that we're still in bondage?
Yeah, all the time.
Yeah, we're not free people in this world.
I can't walk through here, bro, and hold his hand. They'll think I'm nuts. They'll accuse me of all sorts of things. I'm psychopath or something. Yeah, but two women can do it.
It's time we stood up for our rights. Sodomy is still a law in this country. And I'd like to see that law removed.
Yeah.
You feel attracted to a man, you feel attracted to a man.
Well, I enjoyed it because the people,
vibe. Yeah, the people were active.
Gay people are the only people that's got a vibe.
Just in the way, staring into
Moreover, these nowadays, gay life is the best of them all. Because really, there's always peace. I stay there with them in Kwatem. I'm next to Togo's Mama Togo's place. They've got respect. They love each other. Each and every time they're happy. No hatred. If they've met, if there is somebody had a squabble with somebody else. No, they just solved it right away now. It's finished. Then nobody says, I'm going to stab you. You know, like torches they are doing this nowadays. So if ever my boys were gay, or my girls were gay, I would never have any trouble.